Hello friends, we Team Current Affairs Review welcome you to the video discussion on planning in India before and after NITI Aayog. Economic planning is a systematic method to remove the flaws and deficiencies of an economy. Successful implementation of economic planning has already been experienced by multiple nations across the world. Economic planning is a procedure through which limited resources are skillfully used in order to achieve desired economic goals. It is helpful in finding out the solution to the three major basic problems of an economy: what to produce, how to produce, and for whom to produce. The basic features of an economic planning are fixing economic goals, achieving all the set goals within specific time period with all possible efforts, having a chief planning authority with proper knowledge on the available economic resources within the country, and efficient and optimum utilization of the available limited resources to bring out the maximum possible output and welfare. India is a mixed economy, which means that both the public and private enterprises coexist. In a mixed economy, it is the duty of the state to direct its policy so as to secure justifiable distribution, control, and ownership of the available resources of the community and prohibit wealth concentration in just few hands. Economic planning in India was implemented to enhance the economic growth and rise of standard of living of the citizens through development of agriculture, transport, power, industry, and communication, along with other sector in the economy. Economic planning in India find its genesis in 1934 when M. Vishweshwaraya proposed economic planning in India for the very first time in his book titled Planned Economy for India. Thereafter, in 1938, a national economic plan was demanded by the All India Congress Committee, and subsequently a national planning committee was set up under the chairmanship of Jawaharlal Nehru. In 1944, a group of 8 eminent Indian capitalists formulated the Bombay Plan, followed by the Gandhian Plan by Sriram Narayan Agrawal and People Plans by M.N. Roy. In 1950, Jayaprakash Narayan came out with the Sarvodaya Plan. Post-independence, a Committee on Economic Planning for India was constituted under Jawaharlal Nehru's chairmanship. Based on the recommendations of this committee, Planning Commission was constituted in 1950, which came out with first 5 years plan in 1951. There have been 12 5-year plans since then, until the Planning Commission was scrapped in 2015. The first and second plan were aimed at rapid agricultural development, achieving self-sufficiency in food, rapid industrialization, and increasing the public resources at large for investment in public sectors. The main focus of third plan was on increasing exports. Between the third and fourth plan, there was a break in the planning process because of the conflict between Indo-Pak and Indo-China, followed by unprecedented drought, currency devaluation, a general hike in prices, and erosion of resources. The period was termed as plan holiday, and annual plans were rolled out during this period. The fourth plan was formulated when a crisis on balance of payment was prevailing and focused mainly on growth and stability and progressive achievement of self-reliance. The fifth plan focused on eradicating poverty and attaining self-reliance. The sixth and seventh plan were basically infrastructural plans which focused on raising resources for infrastructure development. Due to the fast-changing political affairs during the period of 1990 to 1991 and 1991 to 1992, annual plans were laid out. The eighth plan commenced in the midst of the severe economic crisis, enormous debt burden, and industrial recession. The eighth plan prioritized on developing human resources. The ninth plan was laid down with a focus on growth with social justice and equity. The 10th plan became more ambitious in terms of wide-ranging objectives addressing each and every aspect of the economy. The 11th plan coined the concept of inclusive growth and set out monitorable and quantifiable targets for both center and states. The 12th and final plan focused on creating employment opportunities, reducing gender discrimination, reducing malnutrition, providing electricity, safe drinking water, and providing banking services to over 90% households. However, the Planning Commission had many shortcomings, such as lack of structural mechanism in formulation of plans, deficiency in funds, inefficient administrative machineries, escalation of costs, delay or time overrun in executing schemes and projects, huge gestation periods taken by huge projects, underutilization of resources in several key and heavy industries, inadequate implementation, lack of monitoring and evaluating skills. Because of these problems, a new institutional framework was needed. The National Institute for Transforming India, or NITI Aayog, was established in 2015, replacing the Planning Commission. It has entrusted with the objective of reimagining the agenda of development. The NITI Aayog has been mandated to be the government's think tank, foster cooperative federalism, redefine all agendas of reforms, and develop indicative policies, plans, and programs. The NITI Aayog has done massive amount of work in very short time. It started designing strategic policies, promoting cooperative federalism, providing knowledge and innovation support, besides undertaking evaluation and monitoring major investments. The NITI Aayog also appraised the 12th five-year plan. However, the functions and jurisdiction of the NITI Aayog are not properly sketched, about which even the members of the NITI Aayog have complained. The policies designed by the NITI Aayog are in the form of recommendations, and further, there are no follow-through on these recommendations. The NITI Aayog is just an advisory body which cannot allocate funds and policies. In contrast, the Planning Commission was a body with years of experience which could have come handy in the current economic situation. It would have been rational to overhaul the Planning Commission and weed out the shortcomings rather than abolish it. India is still a developing economy and needs economic planning with set targets for its limited resources and challenges it is facing. Download material for this issue from our website. Please like, subscribe and hit the bell icon. Thank you.